Big Time Adolescence is a Hulu original movie directed and written by Jason Orley and stars Pete Davidson and Griffin Gluck. This was a movie that I had sort of had on my radar for a pretty long time after Pete Davidson mentioned it in his stand-up special, Live from New York. He also mentioned another movie, The King of Staten Island, that I'm very, very excited for. Anyway, seeing how I'm a big fan of his brand of comedy, I was very psyched to see how it would translate into a movie. What I wasn't expecting from this movie would be how unique it is. And while I'm going to contradict myself slightly when talking about the flaws of the movie, this movie has such a unique style and relatable story that I couldn't help but really like it, flaws and all. I was kind of worried about this movie just being Pete Davidson the movie, with Pete just riffing the entire time while he tried to build an actual story around him. And what we got was kind of the opposite. He really doesn't do any of his usual shtick throughout the movie. While I really like his sense of humor and his style of comedy, seeing him scale back and actually become the character was surprisingly great. It made his character feel more like a real person. The excellent script and direction from Jason Orley also really made the movie stand out more than it really had any right to. Each character, besides one, which I'll get to, felt fleshed out and completely real. I felt like these characters were just hanging out. And I mean that in the best way possible. Most of the scenes felt natural and like we were watching real people, letting the comedy and emotion flow naturally throughout the movie, not like they were going through the motions of a standard comedy. The decisions the characters make in the movie feel real. There isn't a big fight or the second act breakup that usually happens in comedies. The conflicts come from situations and the decisions of the characters that all feel realistic and build on each other. And the creative and stylized direction from Jason Orley only enhances the overall vibe of the movie. Speaking of which, probably my favorite part of the movie is just the overall vibe of it. This movie just feels like real life. No punches are pulled, even though it isn't anything that dark. All the characters feel real, none of the situations feel cartoony or ridiculous. It's a very low-key, more chilled-out movie than I was expecting it to be, and it felt very genuine as a result. While I did really, really enjoy this movie, I can't say that I loved it completely. Its lack of any plot can make it feel a little unfocused at times. Some of the story elements that are used in the movie are a little generic, and the main character's high school friend in the movie is extremely irritating. Everything about it, from the performance to the writing, is just ugh. He ruins any scene he's in. The movie also feels way too short. It's kind of missing half of a second act. While I'm not asking for the usual second act breakup, I would have liked to see a little more development during that time. Overall, Big Time Adolescence was a pretty unique and genuine hangout movie. While I can't say it's one of my favorite comedies of all time or anything like that, it's not really trying to be that. The movie is just trying to be a genuine and charming movie while telling a rather unique story about characters that feel like real people. It's being a hangout movie, and it's doing that really, really well. And for really the most part, it succeeds at being that hangout movie. Big Time Adolescent gets a very strong B. Thank you guys so much for watching the video, and I will see you guys next time with another review.